A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 21st Feb, on the front page you have CAA will cause Muslims to face exclusion, US panel. So this is US Commission on International Religious Freedom, which has released a fact sheet on Citizenship Amendment Act. And it says there are serious concerns that CAA serves as a protective measure for non-Muslims in case of exclusion from nationwide NRC. And it says the purpose is evident from BJP politicians' rhetorics. And with the CAA in place, Muslims would primarily bear the punitive consequences of exclusion from the NRC, which would include statelessness, deportation, or prolonged detention. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi has made it clear that the country won't budge on CAA. Then here you have Supreme Court interlocutors examine alternative routes. So on the second day of dialogue, Shaheenbagh protesters propose traffic solutions. So Supreme Court has appointed interlocutors. Government has not spoken to anti-CAA protesters at Shaheenbagh who have been protesting for more than months now. And here on the second day of dialogue of Supreme Court appointed interlocutors, alternative traffic routes are being proposed because the petition which came before Supreme Court was these protesters are blocking traffic. And below you have 28 NTCA protesters issued recovery notices of rupees 64 lakh. So these are 28 persons in Lucknow who have been asked to pay around 64 lakh as recovery for damage to private and public property during the protests against the Citizenship Amendment Act at Parivartan Chowk on 19 December. On page 8 you have Supreme Court passes interim order on Mahadayi Tribunal Server. So this is regarding Mahadayi River, which is also known as Mandovi River in Goa. It is a dispute between river water sharing is a dispute between Karnataka, Maharashtra and Goa. So Supreme Court has presently passed an interim order on order allowing an application by Karnataka state to notify Mahadayi Water Dispute Tribunal's award. So the implementation of the award would be subject to the final judgment of the Supreme Court in the civil appeals which have been filed by Karnataka, Goa as well as Maharashtra. So each of them has challenged the allotment of the water from Mahadayi River among them. On page 9 you have Supreme Court dismisses curative petition by kin of Uphar fire victim. So this is regarding Uphar fire which was in Uphar cinema in Delhi 1997, and the owners actually had been arrested. In this fire 59 people died. So the fire occurred during a movie screening. So the Supreme Court has got curative petitions now filed by the victims of the Uphar theater fire tragedy against Sushil and Gopal Ansal, the owners, for negligence. So here Supreme Court has now dismissed the curative petition. So order as such, which was given a majority judgment in 2017, partially reviewed the original order of 2015 and decided to send real estate baron Gopal Ansal back to jail for a year while sparing his elder brother from serving time behind bars due to his advanced age. Then this is bulk of Jharkhand's deleted ration cards weren't fake. So 18 died due to starvation in the past 3 years. And here you can see almost 90% of ration cards deemed fake and deleted by the Jharkhand government between 2016 and 2018 actually belong to existing valid households, according to this new study by economists affiliated to Abdul Latif Jamil Poverty Action Lab. So this is at Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT. USA. So this randomized control study found that almost 56% of those deleted ration cards were not linked with Aadhaar. Over the last 3 years, at least 18 starvation deaths have been reported due to lack of access to subsidized food, mostly because beneficiaries' ration cards were not linked to Aadhaar. So this is a huge cause of concern. And this is NEET applies to UG courses too, says Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court has upheld the validity of applying National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test, NEET, for admissions to undergraduate courses under Union Ministry of Ayush, Ayurveda, Yoga, Naturopathy, Unani, Siddha, Sova, Rigpa and Homeopathy. So court has agreed with the government that admissions to BMS, BUMS, BSMS and BHMS would require candidates to score minimum qualifying marks for NEET. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Trump cards. So this is regarding President Donald Trump's visit to India. It says even if the Trump's visit yields no big deal, some agreement on trade will be made. So this is expected by US President Donald Trump is on a visit to India. And this is regarding art of life. This is assisted reproductive techniques bill. So this bill was also in news. So it says this is a much needed complement to surrogacy bill. So surrogacy bill also relates to reproduction, relates to childbirth, and this is also regarding the same assisted reproductive techniques. We have this bill, Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act. So together all three, and other, and also the older one, Preconception and Prenatal Diagnostic Technique Act, presents a bouquet of legislation, it says, that will have a positive impact on reproductive rights and choices of women in India. So this assisted reproductive technology bill is to regulate clinics offering fertility treatments. So they need to be regulated. Then the lead article is Losing a Nation in 7 Acts. So this is regarding a Turkish journalist's recent book on her country's descent into dictatorship. And this article says that this is a troubling message for India, that how the country entered into dictatorship and lost its character. So this is the title of the book, How to Lose a Country. So in this book of the Turkish writer, she says, she's a Turkish journalist and writer. She describes how her homeland, that is Turkey, was stolen from her. She considers the president as a dictator. She calls dictatorship of Recep Tayyip Erdogan. So here you can see she says how this was done in 7 steps. First, she says there was a movement created that claimed to be of and for the real people. Then there was assault on rationality and on language. New meanings are thrust upon old terms. An argument is replaced by aggressive slogans. Then she said, shedding of all the shame and decency on the part of the leaders happened, who then teach their followers to do so as well, in the name of authentic indigeneity. Then came dismantling or co-opting of all the institutions, all checks and balances brought under the control of the executive power, including the judiciary, the media and the constitution. The fifth step, she says, was designing of new citizens who will be pre-calibrated to the new normalcy that has been speedily established. Sixth step, she says, is reduction of all liberal and secular thinking people to a stage of irrelevance and despair where they can only laugh at the horror that their country has become. And seventh and the last step is that when the new rulers build their own country, having crushed all possible sources of resistance to the agendas. So the article says this has strong relevance for India. It has a troubling message for India. And this is gearing up to fight the next big viral outbreak. So this is regarding new coronavirus. So this article says that Indian states should regularly test their preparedness to not just diagnose and treat disease, but also to prevent them. Then on the op-ed page on Fridays, we have this parlay coverage. So new counter view are given on a particular issue. So this question is, what distinguishes welfare measures from freebies? So it says adequate fiscal space and socioeconomic context should be the basis of welfare policies. So generally before elections, free things are announced, so they are not long lasting, but the welfare measures should be long lasting. They should be based on the fiscal strength of the state or the country and on the socioeconomic context, what is the requirement. And this is advantage hardliners. So this talks about reformists eroding in Iran. So legitimacy of the reformists is eroding, ending in Iran, and hardliners are expected to win big there. On page 12, you have CJI alarmed at hasty death warrants. So Chief Justice of India Sharad Bobde expressed alarm about the trial courts issuing death warrants in undue haste, without even offering condemned prisoners a chance to exhaust their efforts for commutation or clemency. So this has been reacted to strongly. The court referred to its May 2015 judgment, which had quoted a saying ascribed to Emperor Ashoka that the state should not punish with vengeance, to take revenge. Then below you have A.R. Rahman's NGO gets FCRA license. So this is an NGO by A.R. Rahman. It has got foreign funding. So foundation was in trouble earlier due to charges of tax evasion. So FCRA licenses of 20,674 NGOs were cancelled from 2012 onwards. And even in 2015, few more. So here you can see A.R. Rahman's NGO now gets FCRA license to along with 20 more non-governmental organizations. On international page, you have Bloomberg comes under attack at democratic debate. So Michael Bloomberg faced a barrage of attacks at his first democratic presidential debate. So he wishes to go for presidential elections. So through the Democratic Party, he is a billionaire. And his free spending and fast as such has and his record on race, history and sexist comments and the use of his massive fortune to muscle his way into the contest has resulted in criticism against him. And this is regarding the recent attack which took place in Germany. So it was a 43-year-old German Tobias R. who was found dead at his home following an hour-long manhunt. So, the body of his 72-year-old mother was also found at the flat. So, it was a murder-suicide which took place. So, he was suspected of having far-right beliefs. He killed 9 people at a shisha bar in a cafe in German city of Hanau. So, Angela Merkel, German Chancellor also reacted to this, saying racism is a poison, hatred is a poison, and this poison exists in our society and it is already to blame for far too many crimes. Then below these are continuation of old news regarding US Taliban deal, which will come forth soon. So we'll discuss when it comes. This is regarding again coronavirus, first virus that happened in South Korea. Then on business page you have vehicle registration sputter, slide 7% on poor sentiment. So lack of demand boosters in budget impacts retail auto sector as such in January 2020. So this is what FADA data shows, that is Federation of Automobile Dealers Associations. This is economy needs more monetary stimulus, says Shaktikant Das, RBI governor. So minutes of meeting of RBI show accommodative stance has been favored. So he has observed certain green shoots and also acknowledged that the economy needed further monetary stimulus. So central bank was open to cutting interest rates further too. These are the minutes of the monetary policy committee meeting which was held in February. Then this is world's second biggest control center for goods train set to roll. So this will be Operations Control Center for Goods Train, which will be built in India by the Dedicated Freight Corridor Corporation of India. So this is ready to begin operations and is likely to be inaugurated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi by the end of this month. And this is ICRA revises outlook on Indian pharma industry to negative. So shift from stable amid likely virus impact on China supplies. So this has gone from stable to negative because of new coronavirus. So this is credit rating agency ICRA, Indian credit rating agency, which has revised its outlook. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.